Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Kneon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
For now.
For now, yes.
You're going to go help Mama Sparkles.
It's the last time, yes. I think so.
Hopefully. She's going to go help Mama Sparkles, but while I have her, we're going to give you some dismal Disney news.
Yeah, what else is new?
Every day is dismal Disney news. We're going to talk about how a bloodbath has come to the House of Mouse. According to Disney insiders, things are pretty bad. They're cutting loose a bunch of executives. And yeah, it's not good.
I like the picture you chose. How did you even think of that one?
Because I like Fantasia.
Okay.
Mickey's sharpening his axe to cut loose those executives. I guess it's about time they cut loose some executives. Not that
right.
I want anyone to lose their jobs, but they've been laying off frontline workers now for months.
Mm-hmm.
And now Disney is going to chop execs, and we're going to talk about that and some of the other stuff going on with Disney's dismal financial state. We told you so. Hate to say I told you so, but
yeah,
we said so.
We kept saying, we've been saying for months, there's going to be more cuts coming. There's going to be more cuts coming. And we've been telling you. And then here it comes, and they're like, oh, this is a surprise. It's like, not really.
No.
Not really.
Complete unsurprise.
Yeah.
So before we get into it, please give us a sub. Sub for more content. We do talk about Disney. We talk about movies. We talk about pop culture, comics, whatever interests us that day. A lot of animation. We talk about the animation industry. And if you want to check out our merchandise at shopclownfish.com, I'll put a link in the comments. We have a pre-order up right now for pins.
I can't wait to get the angry me one.
Yeah, we have an angry geeky, raging geeky.
Not on pin form yet, but we have a shirt design we haven't put up yet.
But we also have a lot of holiday merch. So if you want to help support the channel, we don't have a Patreon or anything like that. We very seldom do live streams. This is the best way to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So here we go. This is actually coming from The Hollywood Reporter. And I put a post up on Pirates and Princesses, but they said there are more than 100 staffers being impacted by Thursday's layoffs. That was yesterday. It came in late in the afternoon. Of course, it always does.
Well, I'm wondering if these are the layoffs they announced was going to happen to people. Well, no, I guess a different amount of layoffs. That was 1,800. These are those that was going to be in California. And they had different kinds of jobs that were going to be impacted. And I think this might be, these might be different positions.
Because yeah,
those are more like the fire department and like, you know, painters and stuff like that. And now we have executives and such. But the reason I brought that up is because they had theirs, it's going to be done in stages.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder if they're going to be, we're going to see more layoffs here in corporate. It's just going to be done in stages.
Well, they said before, last time they laid a bunch of people off and they were talking about the restructuring. We're going to talk about the restructuring because that really is key to all of this. But they said that they were actually going to go through the film and television divisions.
Mm-hmm.
And start laying people off there. They might cut back on productions, which would explain things like DuckTales, you know, getting the axe.
Mm-hmm.
And really nobody is safe at Disney at this point. Very few people are safe. Now, this goes back to the restructuring that they announced a couple of months ago. That Bob Chapek is saying, hey, we're going to put all of our television and movie content basically under one banner. And it's going to be designed for essentially Disney Plus first.
Right.
And that's what they're doing. So a lot of these layoffs are in. We've got an ABC exec, Vicky Dumer.
I think it's funny because, wait, go back to the top of the page. It pulled up these things and it pulled up Dumb and Dumber.
Dumb and Dumber.
So
oh, my God.
That.
I'm sorry.
I was like, I bet it's because of her name.
Yeah, but she's getting gone. Another ABC exec, VP of Scheduling, Andy Kubitz, is getting gone. Dan Kupetz.
Not to be confused.
Not to be confused with Andy Kubitz. He was a 20th Century Fox person. They're laying off personalities at ESPN. They're canceling shows. And they're getting rid of Radio Disney completely after 25 years. Now, Radio Disney, people are like, what's the big deal? I'm like, well, this station basically made the careers of Miley Cyrus, Selena Gomez, Demi Lovato.
Well, they promote the heck out of people on Disney Channel and stuff. And Radio Disney has had stuff on Disney Channel all the time.
Yeah. So it's for them to shut that down, too, means that music is not that important to Disney anymore.
Right. They're shutting down Disney Country too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Everything. First quarter next year, 25 years on the air. And they're like, yep, we're done. We're out. They're not even going to like, you think they'd like Spotify it or something. And
we're pulling the plug.
And I think we're going to see a lot of this because here's the problem. You know, I don't see Disney returning to its former glory anytime soon.
No. And of the parks being, you know, most of the parks are closed. I think, was it Disneyland Paris is closed?
Yeah.
Was it a Hong Kong shutdown again?
Yeah, I have that.
Hong Kong shutdown again. Disneyland, we already know they were allowing shopping, but now that they have increased cases in California, they're talking like curfews and stay-at-home orders and things like that around LA. I mean, that's more going to hit Universal, but it's going to hit Disneyland as well, probably. And then, well, Disney World's the only one that's up, you know, domestically. And even then, they have caps, but I think the caps keep getting raised. But you know, they have a lot of stuff there and people aren't traveling. They just aren't traveling because, you know, the cases are going up across the country and some states are putting in mandates for, you know, quarantines or different things like that. Or you have to fly and people are afraid to fly at the airports because they said the airports are awful.
Yeah.
So people are just, you know, they're just not going. So even if they're open, it doesn't mean people are going to go. I think a lot of people, they get down there are like, you know, locals.
Yeah, that's the thing. And where most of the revenue comes from for Disney World is actually the hotels.
Mm-hmm.
They need people from out of state to stay at the hotels, which are jacked up. But last time we were there, there were very few people in the Contemporary.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't seem, I mean, and that's...
It wasn't that bad, no.
No.
The rooms were black. I would never spend that much money on a room there again.
But, I mean, we see what Universal is doing, that they actually shut a lot of their hotels down because they knew there was a decreased demand, despite the fact that at least for like Halloween Horror Nights, you know, they had some pretty high crowd levels.
Well, Disney World, I think, and I think Universal have been hitting capacity like last week and stuff. During Thanksgiving week, obviously, they were closing because they were hitting capacity.
Yeah. And that's it, you know. But the thing is, they can't really, how much more blood can they get out of Disney World? Disney World can't bankroll the entire travel industry for Disney. The cruise ships are down. You were just talking about that today. They're down.
Yeah, the cruise ships have been canceled. The cruises are getting canceled through February of 2021, which we weren't surprised by because they didn't have anything bookable until March. So people are like, oh, surprise. I'm like, it was not a surprise. They didn't have bookable cruises till March. So Disney canceling the cruises in February was just a matter of time. And if you follow along at all, you knew that. So they just canceled those. We don't know when they're going to come back up because even if they go through the you know, path to reopening for cruise lines, they have to go through three steps. And some of them require, you know, mock cruises and all kinds of certifications and things. It could be a while till they get those back up. But at this point, we're hitting a year for some of the ships. I forget which one it was off the top of my head. Has been closed for a year. By the time you hit February, they've been closed for a year. And then pretty soon after February, like in March, you're starting to see the other cruise lines would have been closed for a year.
What's the maintenance like on that? I mean, can you keep a ship offline for a year?
Well, they still have crew on it, and they're still boating it around, you know, to different ports. But, yeah, and then I'm wondering how – okay, so with the cancellations, if you paid in full, you got 125% credit you can use for another booking. And you have to use it before – they keep pushing it back. Now it's May 31st, 2022. So you figure, say they come back online in April or May of next year. That gives people a year to use it. But you're talking about a whole year full of cruises that have been canceled.
Yeah.
So now some people who hadn't paid in full, they just automatically were refunded. Those who were paid in full were given the credit if they wanted it. So you have a year full of cruises that they've already taken money for that they're not going to have half that money because a lot of people are booking their cruises in that year time frame to use their credits. And they gave them 25% extra credit. So people that they were needing money for, you know what I mean, new bookings aren't going to be anywhere near the level they need it to be. So they're going to just be coasting on fumes for a couple of years. Even if bookings are up in 2021, early 2022, doesn't mean they're making money because they're already probably a lot of people that they're owed cruises.
Yeah.
They're owed cruises at this point.
Yeah, I don't know what's going to happen with this because apparently they're still moving forward with the cruise ships, which I think is kind
of
a stupid decision.
Because
cruise lines, I mean, they're talking.
They've already paid for them or a bunch on them.
Yeah, well, at least the one for sure, the Wish, I guess they're
gonna... He said in the meeting they're moving forward on all of them.
Well, he's like, well, within 5 years we'll be okay.
Yeah, basically. And they probably will come back eventually, but not they keep raising prices the way they've been. But anyway, back to what you're doing. They were talking about they're basically trying to shrink down that stuff and put most of their eggs into the basket of Disney Plus.
Yeah.
And because of it, they're now going and, you know, eliminating redundancies in more positions. You said people at Hulu are kind of getting nervous.
Yeah, so it's interesting about that because Hulu executives now, they're worrying. And I have to wonder if it isn't about the rumors of Disney 18+.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they're going to have their meeting, what, next week? The 10th. You know, there was a leak that there is an 18+ version of Disney coming that's going to have R-rated content on it. The thing is, most of that R-rated mature content has been on Hulu.
Well, I think they're doing the Disney 18 plus because they want to do like what HBO just did and take all the, or take, you know, Warner put all their, going to put all their releases on HBO.
Yeah.
They have to have that to put it on Disney plus and be able to use the premium pass. You have to, when they've been saying it's a family channel, it's a family channel since the beginning. They can't put things like Black Widow on there unless they have another, you know, tab to put it under that's 18 plus. So I think that's 100% we're going to see that. And the whole purpose of it is to be able to put things like Black Widow and some of their other more adult films they have coming out onto that Disney 18 plus, so they can charge premium pass access for it.
Right.
They don't want that on Hulu. They want that on Disney plus.
And that would be any of the Fox stuff. Now they greenlit Deadpool 3. That's mm-hmm. probably going to be an R-rated movie.
Oh, they said it was going to be R for sure.
Yeah, yes. And they got to have a place to put it. But again, historically, it would have been on Hulu because that's right. where all the Fox content is, the FX content, unless the long-term plan for Disney is everything becomes Disney Plus, and there's Disney Plus and Disney 18 Plus, and then Hulu goes away.
I don't know, because they just jacked the price on Hulu for those who have the live TV, mm-hmm. Hulu. It's up to what, like $65 or $66 and $71 now, depending if you have ads or not, even though honestly having the no ads really makes no difference. They jacked it again $10. So last year at the same time, they jacked it $10. And right after Disney got, or right before Disney got control, full control of Hulu, March of 2019, in February of 2019, they raised it $5 then. So you're talking in a matter of less than 2 years after Disney got control, we're talking $25 jack up in price on Hulu live TV. And 20 of that has just been in the last year.
Yeah. I mean, it's the point now where we're paying as much for Hulu with TV as we did for like a basic DirecTV.
And you don't get as many channels.
You don't get as many channels. You get, and I'm wondering what's going to happen there, because like half of the channels on Hulu Live TV are Discovery channels, and Discovery is going to launch their own streaming service.
Right.
So I got to wonder if what's going to happen eventually is like there won't be live TV anymore. It's like you just subscribe to Disney, subscribe to Discovery, subscribe to HBO, and that's how you watch TV, and that's it.
Well, if Hulu, yeah. if they lose a bunch of those channels that are Discovery, where they're doing Discovery Plus, if they lose all those channels, you know, too, it's like at that point, how can they justify charging so much for live TV? And then it makes you wonder if they are going to roll it all into one thing. I don't know. But I do know they're jacked the price again. On Hulu Plus. I do know Disney 18 Plus makes sense. Disney Plus 18 Plus? Is that Disney Plus Plus?
I don't know.
There's a new way of saying, you have triple X. If you turn those pluses sideways, there's Disney X.
Disney X.
And yeah. Disney XX. And, I do think they're doing that just because they're going to take all these movies and dump them onto it. I think we're going to find all this stuff out on the 10th, most likely.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what's probably going to happen. And I think they're going to keep cutting now. Going back to other divisions, we've been for quite some time saying Marvel Comics as a comic book publisher could potentially end. They just canceled a whole bunch of mm-hmm. comics, including a bunch of Star Wars comics, mm-hmm. including the Rise of Skywalker adaptation, which that will be the first time a Star Wars movie has not had a comic book adaptation. And they had already started working on it. It was already solicited, and they pulled the plug on it.
Well, that's just dumb, because at that point, they already did most of the work, so what was the point? You know what I mean? Because they lose money.
Unless it just wasn't coming together. I mean, I'm kind of getting, starting to feel like they're going to cut corners wherever they can cut it. They were laying freelancers off. We saw with other Marvel comics that they were reusing artwork. Because, again, that's even if you do it for a couple pages, that's like two or three pages you don't have to pay for.
Mm-hmm.
Anything you can do to cut corners.
That isn't a new thing. They've done something like that before.
Yeah, but Marvel's not been that. Usually if you see budget cuts like that, it's at companies like Boom or IDW, mm-hmm. not Marvel Comics. Marvel Comics has always been top shelf, and it sounds like...
Not lately.
And I think I can totally see Disney coming in like they like Warner did with DC Comics and just gutting it. Completely.
They need to. They made a lot of bad decisions. People in charge of Marvel, frankly, made a lot of bad decisions. Backed things they should never have backed. And then when the fans, instead of listening to the fans who support them and buy their product because of who they chose to run it and create this stuff, they just decided to scree and call them names and then alienate people and block them on Twitter and all this other stuff. And they literally just, took all their money and just threw it out the window.
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, at this point, they need to have somebody come in there and be like, what the hell's wrong with you people, and fix it.
That is assuming that Disney cares. And at this point, I don't know if Disney even gives
I don't know if they do either. They just want the IP, and they already have tons of it, so they don't really need it.
They're just making it up as they go. With Marvel, like, they're just making it up as they go now.
Well, they own all the old stuff, and that's what they're basing their movies on, is the old stuff. So they don't even need the new stuff. The new stuff doesn't sell.
No.
They could close it down tomorrow and still have years worth of movie fodder.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, call it a day.
Yeah, they haven't even scratched the surface of, you know, decades of X-Men.
You know, ideas were good and usable.
Yeah, when the things were usable. So there we go, guys. I think we're going to see a lot of cutbacks coming.
We're going to see probably more things, but more people being cut.
Yeah, absolutely. And don't be surprised. Nothing is off the table with Disney. They're actually in much worse shape than they're letting on. It is what it is.
I'm sorry if people don't like hearing it. We don't make it. We don't control this. We just report on it. Sorry if you don't like it.
All right, so we're going to wrap it up.
Yep.
Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants. And we'll talk later.
Bye.